what's up, you guys? Bloody Jacob here.
Can I see your invitation, please?
Sure. Here's my invitation.
I had to learn how to begin again. It's alright. Move on. Hey, hey, little Tommy Gunn. I guess we're never gonna end up the lucky ones. Hope I never see you again. Have around on me love. Hallelujah. Nobody wins. But have around on me friend. If I never see you again. Have around on me friend.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Bloody Jacob here to bring you another horror movie review. This time we're going to be talking about Summer of 84. Summer of 84 is a movie I've been wanting to talk about for some time now. It just got kind of shuffled. I seen it a few weeks ago, but it's definitely one I still want to talk about at some point. One of my favorite YouTubers over the past few months has actually been Cody Leach. He tends to do a lot of horror movie reviews. He does a lot of ranking videos, things like that. He collabed with Chris Stuckman at one point, one of my other favorite YouTubers in general. Summer of 84 was his favorite horror movie of 2018, I think it was. Yeah, it did come out in 2018. And it was one of his two favorite movies of the whole year, so that made me think I should probably check this one out. I watched it on Verve, on their Shudder channel. So yeah, I was curious. I mean, it's a pretty simple premise, you know, it is in the 80s. And it follows this group of kids as they suspect that one of their neighbors is a serial killer and connected to all these murders that have been going around. And that's pretty much it there. And right away you get some noticeable like Stranger Things comparisons and or like It with the Losers Club, and yeah, all that is pretty evident. But before we get into that, I do gotta talk about that these group of kids though are pretty good together. I especially liked our two sort of main ones. Graham Vercher played Davy Armstrong here, and Caleb Emery played Dale Woody Woodsworth, the bigger fellow there. The other two were good too, though. The one with the leather jacket sort of reminds me of the brother character from Stranger Things a little bit. But they all have pretty good chemistry together. I mean, like those. Yeah, they feel like they have a natural friendship together. It feels organic. You feel like they are kind of just, you know, kids. They feel, the way they talk and what they're into, it seems appropriate for how old they are and stuff like that. I think that works pretty well. And then you also have sort of this love interest. Nikki, played by Tira. I can't pronounce her last name. But she did a good job, too. I think she's pretty good with emotion as well. She fit in like a glove. There's the whole plot point of her being Davy's babysitter when they were both a little bit younger, which seems a little bit weird, but you know, they're obviously not overly far apart in age. And yeah, then you have Rich Sommer as Wayne Mackey. He's the neighbor in question. He's also a cop of the town. And a lot of the movie is kind of teetering line, okay, is this guy creepy? Is he really giving off all these warning signals? Are our group of kids here justified? Or is they going to take the turn and have him just really be a decent guy and they get themselves into a lot of trouble for, you know, trying to get into something like they don't know much about and then they find the real killer or something? I don't know. I'm not going to spoil it for you because, like, probably how the movie goes in the end is the best thing it has going for besides the cast, I guess. And now, like I said, it does definitely remind you a lot of you know, different projects like Stranger Things or It. Those movies are, or those types of stories are pretty popular these days. You know, kids looking into like a town mystery, whether it's supernatural or not, and stuff like that. So for that, you know, it kind of does bring it down a little bit because it's not overly original at all. Now I did see that the I think it was the director or writer said it was actually written before Stranger Things came out. They just had to shop it around a little bit longer because of the conclusion being a bit different. You know, which I'm sure is true. I don't think he's lying about that. But the fact is that the studio decided to release it probably when they seen how popular things like Stranger Things were. So still, it does not feel overly original because of when it's been put out. And I won't say the cast is overall better than either of those either, but they're still pretty good. And it has a good pacing to it. It doesn't feel like it drags on or anything. You know, it's a pretty easy watch. And like I said, I'm not going to spoil it. I'm not going to say how it ends, but it is pretty controversial. It does take a different turn. It could disturb some people. I'm not saying it's totally that way, but it definitely leaves things off on different notes. So yeah, I was surprised. I was taken back by it. But I'll just say, no, you're watching a horror movie here, and in that way you can kind of appreciate when things actually go a certain way, I guess, to try and keep an honesty to the world these characters are in. But you can respect it for that as well. And like I said, it's not totally that way either. Well, but it's definitely worth watching to see how that goes and to see the solid cast. So overall, if I had to rate Summer of 84, I feel like I have to give it another watch, and I probably will eventually, but right now I'm giving it about a B- and 82%. Part of me want to rate it an 84% because, you know, Summer of 84. But just the lack of originality because of when it was put out, and, you know, just kind of feeling like I've seen these sorts of things like this before, it kind of docks it a little bit, but still, very solid cast, some good chemistry, and, you know, I can appreciate the different story direction it took in the third act. So yeah, let me know you guys thought about Summer of 84 if you've seen it. So you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, like, subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.